So this has a bowline knot in it. And see, I'm kind of pushing her, and I need her all the way down at that barn. You get a little bit bigger to push her closer to me. All right. Go out and then in front. There you go. We have helpers.
They're all like curious bystanders.
Yeah. Look at Jimothy.
Did you name her Jennifer?
I said Jimothy.
Oh.
That's what you named her.
Into that corner and then into her shoulder. Into the barn over there that I cleaned out. Push right to that gate that we came in, into that corner. Not that way. That's that. Come on. When you get to right there, stop. Slow watch right there. Just kind of sit down and think about your day, I guess. Question the choices that led you to being here. If I was a horse, I'd be dead. They would have sent me to Mexico by now if I was a horse. Yeah, because nobody would ever catch me and do my feet. Because they'd be scared of me. Language. Buttercup's a good name. Now I'll just stay here and wait for a little while. Let her think about it. Which one?
I'm squeezing to about right there, but watch me. Just stand up and walk. Right there. There you go.
I don't think she's scared of us. I don't think she's been running because she's scared.
Doesn't matter why she's running, we just gotta convince her to not run.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter why she's running. Well, she's running, we need her to not run. So, I'm not saying that it's necessarily scared, but, like, she may not think we're gonna eat her, but she may be worried about us doing something to her, like catching her. I have no clue what they used to do to her, when they did any of that. So, I can't worry about that. I just have to pay attention to what she's doing. What?
Wow.
I know. I'm not directing it at her. That's why she's not running. I can yell like this right next to her, but I'm focusing all my attention out there so she doesn't care because she's right there. If I looked at her like this and then I started yelling, yeah, but they don't care. She hears loud noises all the time.
Come back, right there.
Like, it doesn't matter what energy you're necessarily putting out, as long as you're directing it in the right place.
That's all right.
This doesn't hurt you, Coco. You come in back over here behind me. And then take that. I don't like that barbed wire, Coco. I don't like that barbed wire, Coco. I don't know where the end of it is. I need to get her away from it. me have this.
You get her out of the way and I'll move that barbed wire.
You're a tough little one. Do what? I know. There's no leverage on there. Whoo, that hurt. That's why I used a bowline knot. So it wouldn't choke her when she did that. Hold on. Soft and easy to stand there. All that running got you doing more work. You're out of breath now, aren't you?
Looks like she's getting more flashbacks from kids' birthday parties.
I'm not gonna make you do any work if you just stand and help me out. Okay? You know how to be caught. They must have made you do something like birthday parties.
I don't like kids either, Coco.
We can't catch you, Coco. That's what your mama told me. We can't catch you. No one can catch you. You don't like being caught.
The wild Mustang shall always be free.
Wild and free, free as the wind. You want to go ahead and bring the truck back up over to the barn? There is some tension on it, but every time I completely let up, she balks. But that tiny little bit of tension on the halter is keeping her moving forward with me. As she catches up, I'm letting off a little bit more. There you go. We're gonna walk up. I know. All right. It's kind of nice and dry in here. All right, Sarah. Will you come hold her? I'm gonna give Sarah my gloves.
I lost my phone. I have my own gloves.
Alright, I gotta go get water. I was just trying to get you to come. You have to catch horses so they're good at being caught. Good. I think you know how to be caught. They just didn't make you remember. They forgot to catch you. You didn't forget to be caught. They forgot to catch you.